Yeah, I greet all of you now. My name remains the same, John Ogunjo of Liga Tech International. Now today we want to wrap up all the series of small video where we do since then with respect to the design and construction of the center tap transformer. How you will take design arm, how you will take kind of the smart tool, the transformer, how you take get the transformer. So if you never watch them, go to other videos where we don't show before this time. So today now, one of the conclusive part. If time day, God permits, we will do the windings today. But today, one just the final part, starting from where we started, wrap them up, total load capacity. We don't explain this one. We talk and say, total load capacity. Now, the summation, everything we want to use for your house, we need to know what you want to use for the transformer we want to design. You suppose know how many bulbs you want to use, how many fans you want to use, how many fridges you want to use. You go add up all of it together. But for the sake of this class today, I want to take my house do sample. So we'll design a center tap transformer, we will carry all the loads. So my total load capacity for here now is 1,250 watts. That be everything we did this house here. One ball we did there, two fridge, the television and fans all put together is 1,025 watts. So with this in mind, this one, if you take and peg, you know, the capacity of the transformer where you go use. So if I want advice now, like this one being now, since a dirty load day, what you want to use for here, not suppose less than 3,000. You understand? 3,000, 3,500, even up to 4,000. Because if a dirty load day like a bowl, your transformer, you know, suppose we carry on when the drag current. So me, for this design now, we are going to work on, I want to peg it at 3,000. That is number two. The transformer capacity. You understand? So this one, all the load, where I know I want to design the transformer put might be this. So this one will help me know my transformer capacity. You understand? So as this one be now, what do I get for my what I want to do? I want to peg that for 3,000. Let's use the word VA. Then in the previous lesson, we talk about transformer efficiency. We talked about that efficiency. Don't mind my writing, I know the code. Efficiency for here now, we will use 80%, that is equal to 1.25. So it's going to be 3,750. So 3,750 kVA. VA. It's VA. If it's in kV, it's going to be 3.75 kVA, but we are working with VA. Okay, we've already discussed the importance of efficiency. I told myself because of the loss, those losses are inevitable. Our loss and the colors, they are inevitable, so we need to compensate for them. And as a business, you want to use something wider, you know, if you want to make it tight, well, that one they call, if you want to pack the magnetic coil, put time for inside this one. You know, if it was machine to do one, all those ones are forms of losses. So we are going to work on this. The design is going to be on this. So the next step now, we'll look for a bobbin or a formwork. A formwork that will correspond, that can accommodate this. I told you before, say if you want to know the transformer where we will fit power, particular rating, you need to know the what. This one I need to call what? Transformer core area. As you know, the area now length is breadth. So this one is 9.1 by 6. The core area of this bobbin is 9.2 centimeter times 6 centimeter. 9.2 times 6, 55.2. 55.2 centimeter square, because you don't have two lengths here, so it could be square. Number five, from here now we're gonna calculate the power. You know the formula before. If you never know, I'll go back to those videos. Let's move ahead. Is equal to the core area, if you call it C dot A times this factor 1.15 all raised to the power of 2. 63.48 is the power 2. What does this one mean? We say it means you add times this one 2 times 2, that's 63.48. He can times himself two times. Times 63.48. You understand? So 63.48 times 63 again, 0.48. Now, see what you get. 4,029. Let's say 4,000, if you approximate them, it will be 4,030. Yeah. So you go see, this bobbin will let us take power this load. So it's appropriate for it. It's almost times 3. You understand? It's appropriate for it. So I want to clean the board now. Okay, we'll just quickly just refresh ourselves. This one first toxin and transformer. This one are from this setting. Now this one are the primary side. This one are the secondary side. I want to connect this one to alternative code voltage source. This one now the V1. If not light in the glow, V1 will say go be 240. 240 volts. Then this one are the current. We'll call them I1. Primary current will go flow through this space. This one are the N1, the number of turns. This N1 will represent the number of turns. We want to wind this primary for this framework. Then the other side, the secondary, now center tap. We don't first discuss all these ones. This one, current will flow through here, pass through this load, it will enter here. This one will see flow through like this, it will enter here. So here you will see say A plus B. We just say A plus B, current A plus B is equal to, let's call it I2. You understand? So we have I2 here also, we have N2 and V2. So the formula says that V1 over V2, this one is from derived from transformer equation. We don't need to go into all these ones. Is equal to N1 over N2 is equal to I2 over I1. Over I1. We need to just cram this one and put them for where, because we need them. Yeah? You understand? Those are effects of say whatever power that is generated here is same as the power on this side in an ideal situation. So that's why they say P1, which is the power here, is equal to V2. So whatever you get here, you should also get it on the other side. That's just the idea of using it. Okay, now see, now just to taste with your brain. Time no demo, just try listen them up. Okay, see one side now. Conclusion. See one side down. This one at 12 volts. Now 4030 VA. Understand? Let me this one. See the other one. 24 volts. 4030 VA. So we want just quickly just work the two out. First of all, Moku know the current where this one will carry from on both sides, and the current which one will carry on both sides, current and voltage. It will just say here yeah, now 240. Now 240. You will see how that thing break down. From here to here, 220, you can add top, small top, 240. You understand? Then this side will be the center tab. I can make 10.5. You understand? So if you want to know the total voltage here now, this plus this is going to give you 21 volts. You understand? This one are filament. They use this one for feedback and stabilization of the system, to stabilize the system. Depends on your design for the solid state side, the circuit. If you like, put on, if you like, you put on. Yes. We'll get to that stage, we'll explain that one. So the same thing here now. The primary is 240. I said that tap. So this is 24. You will multiply by 2, it will be 21. Then the filament is 34. Understand? Well, the power here is equal to the power here. Let me this P1 equal to P2. So now what we'll do now, let us look at the current, compare the current. Compare the current, we will flow through here. Through here, through here, through here. You will see, that is where I bring this one come out. Now, power is equal to I, the current times voltage. The power we will talk now be 430 VA, which is equal to current I times the voltage 220 volts, 240 volts. So if you solve for this I, it will be 4,030 VA all over 240 volts to get the primary current here. So see what you get at the end of the day. 16.8 amps, that is the current. And if you solve for the secondary current, it will be 430 divided by 24, the total voltage there. You will get 168 amps. Not to say the current will be here, the high well. And it's going to be very expensive for you to get pure copper. No, we will feel the way we will feel use for this thing. You understand? It's expensive. So, me, I would suggest say, if you want design transformer for inverter, this 12 volts now for maybe from the range of your load will be maybe from 0 to 300 watts or 400 watts. Now you will see we'll use this one.
this one will be for fan, telly, and there just few things that you will feel using songs economically. You will want design, so it's very expensive. So I think we'll just stop on this one now. Let's go to this side. Still of the note, this song is most appropriate. You see, Anna, see the primary voltage, see the secondary voltage, center tap 21, total voltage now 42 volts. You see, see the filament 32 volts. See the primary current now is 18. But you see the secondary current, say drop. Can't drop this one, we can manage this one. You understand? Or the gauge, if you want to go buy and you go check out for standard wire gauge, you will say the thing big and the money we will take back. This one will be easy one. So this one is better and it's less expensive. You understand? So that's that. So now we've gotten the primary and the secondary current for this. This one will wipe off. We'll concentrate on the 24. What we don't get, we don't fit know our total load capacity. VA, the transformer capacity. Transformer capacity is 4030 VA. Transformer core area, we don't calculate on 55.2. Primary current is this, secondary current is this. So the next thing, we will go here. We want to calculate the size of this wire we want to use. And, parameter we will need here. Then call our current density. Current density, they tell us the amount of current we will pass through this gauge at this, maybe at the particular point. How many electrons will be passing? How many current will be passing? At when the temperature is maybe 60 degrees Celsius. You understand? So all those ones you can find out for SWC or AWC. American Standard Wire Gauge. You understand? You can see them for this. So for copper, if you take up to 2.6 current per millimeter square. Or if for aluminum, it will take 1.5 amps per millimeter square. So this information or unit is very important for you to know to determine the size where this 16 amps will figure or 90 amps. We'll see as we calculate and so that we'll tell you the core area of this conductor and also determine the diameter, the thickness of this wire. So that is where this one comes into play. So we've already discussed this one. Then the next thing, we want to look at the conductor core area. The core area, see the formula. Conductor core area of the primary is given by the current of the current rating of the current calculated here, current of the primary over this constant 2.6, which is the copper current density. Then if aluminum now you want to use, you go use this number way there. But here now copper now wanted in the primary. So you now divide by 2.6. Now it is so. This is the primary current divided by 2.6. This one will cancel this. So you will get 6.46 millimeter square as the primary conductor core area. That be this one. Then you will apply the same formula to secondary for the secondary. Primary secondary current is this divided by this. It will give you 64 mm square. From there, you go further to calculate the conductor diameter. Diameter, see how the wire thick, the thickness of the wire. You understand? All these measurements are very important so that you can trace the gauge for your one back. That is why we do it to the. You understand? So, see the conductor diameter. For the primary conductor diameter, see this is called the square root of the primary conductor core area times 4 divided by pi 3.142. 3.142. If you solve that one, you will get 2.88 millimeter. That is the thickness of this wire. That's it. You'll see the pattern for the secondary. So if you solve them up, this one will get 9.03 mm. So now very thick aluminium. No one wants, because see what you use for here for the secondary. Aluminium will use. Here we use copper. So if I want to use a copper here, I'll change this one to 2.6. Show you get. Aluminium is very easy. The question. You don't feel go buy a conductor for myself. Fold them up, insulate and use them. So I knew I want this for here, so that's why I use 1.5. You get it? Okay. Now is the turns by voltage. What did that one mean? You say how many times we will turn your wire to get 1 volt? Or if I turn on 1 volt, how many volts? If I turn on one time, how many volts there? So it's a measure of the number of turns to the voltage where you derive from that turns where you make. You understand? So now this constant 39. now I use. In another video, if you're not interested, just ask me, then I'll tell you how to take the right 39 frequency. Did the frequency we are used for here now 69 I use because of the errors of the component we want to use for our electronics, ROC, audio circuits. You understand? So 39, 60 I use here. 1.2 for the maximum flux density. Stack factor did there. Stack factor here I use 0.85. So if you calculate all those ones, then you will get this 39. But for easy movement, mobility, so we just say transfer load is equal to 39, which is the factor I'm talking about, divided by the transformer core area. Any of this one, once you don't feel measure, just put that factor, divide that now straight. So where core area, transformer core area is equal to 55.2. We don't get here today. So transformer core area 55.2. We don't calculate that one part. Maybe that. So if you solve this one out, you get 0.70 tons. What do this one mean? Say you go turn them. You never know if you reach oneself. 0.70 tons. Right? If you start from here now, you can't reach somewhere here. You don't get 1 volt. So if you go one time now, it's more than 1 volt. You see? 0.70 tons. So if you want to know the number of tons for your primary, it will still be N1. You multiply this constant with the voltage. So here now we have 220 and another one added on top, 20. So we now said N1 is equal to 220 volts times this constant, times by voltage, plus 20 times this times by voltage. So if you solve that one out, you have total of tons, 169.4 tons. You understand? Then the same for the secondary. So now for the 2 volts that I did there, a center tap. So if you calculate it, you will get 29.4. So since the center tap, you need to divide the tons equally into two. So each side will be 40.7. Yeah, now tons here will be Here now will be 14.7 tons. Now you're sitting from here to here, then from this place to this place, you still get 14.7 tons. Then from here to here, 9 minutes 169.4. Here to here. Here to here is 169.4 tons. 9 before here. Then for this 20, 9 be 50.4. Here now, 50.4 tons. Then the other one at 154 tons. 154 tons. So now so it be. So let's see a step, we'll not forget to. The wire we want to turn on, we need to go check. We'll go check system. Check. You get this app where they play. So they call them a wire gauge diameter, conductor diameter. So if you go there, they go ask you of the diameter of the conductor. You will tap up. If you tap up, it will just show you the gauge. You understand? So we'll just do that before we round up.
So see the app. It's called Gauge Check. I download them for Play Store. So let's check it now. Wire size. Then see me enter the millimeter. For the primary, remember I say we said it's 2.88. Press check now. See I'm see the range. So me, I would prefer to use a gauge 12. See I'm see the diameter for the primary. So let's check for the secondary. Secondary was a 96. Is it not? No, 9.03.
Okay.
Check. No, see I'm. A very big gauge. Is that gauge 0 or gauge 1? Very thick. So I would prefer to use gauge 1, which is 7. No. We'll use a gauge. Very thick wire, 8.23 millimeters. You understand? So now, see the checker. You think they easy? But as you go try, when you see and say you put on, you don't anything work, you will be very, 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 very happy. So in the next a workshop, and then we'll come since we don't get all these values, the tons, all these ones we will write for here. So we'll come take and see the tons for this side. See from here to here, see the tons. Here to here, see the tons. So we'll come, we don't already know the gauge. Don't really know the gauge. Then we'll come show now how to turn out. Time not will permit us now. Time don't go. We'll show now how to turn out. Like this will go maybe for weekend. We'll get all the material, show now how to turn. After turning, we'll now test the transformer and see these values for 240 and see whether we'll get these values. All right, that's all. So if you never subscribe, please go and subscribe. And if any question they will never understand, we could ask. Or anywhere they will make mistake, or you get contribution when you want to add. You are very, very welcome. I pray God give us the power. We'll take. Choose life. But your body puts me.